In this video, we'll compare Redis and Memcached. I'll cover some differences in features, but mostly we'll focus on performance. First of all, we'll measure one of the most important metrics for any cache, which is latency, and we'll use P99 percentile. The most common operations for any cache are set and get, so we'll focus on those two. Also, we'll measure throughput by counting how many operations per second each cache can handle, and we'll measure saturation by monitoring CPU usage, memory usage, as well as network traffic. I run all my tests using AWS and exactly the same infrastructure that I use in my production environments. For this test, I used M7A medium instances for Redis and Memcached, since Redis famously uses mostly a single thread and does not scale vertically well. I also use EKS cluster with Graviton instances to run my monitoring components and clients to generate load. Let's say you have a typical three-tier architecture. You have a client, which could be a browser or a mobile application. Then you have a logic tier with your application and business logic. And you have a data tier to persist all the data. Let's say you have an e-commerce website where all your customer data along with the products stored in a relational database. Every time a customer logs into their account, you need to display their name, maybe the shipping address, and some other details. That data is not frequently changed, but with every request, you need to query your database to display that information. It's fine if you have a few customers, but if you have thousands, these queries can quickly become slower and slower. So what you can do when the customer logs into their account is query the database for the data once and store it temporarily, let's say for 60 seconds in the cache. This will improve user experience by loading a website quicker and removing the load from your database. You can also cache other SQL queries, maybe for the most purchased products to display them on the front page and stuff like that. This was original problem that caches solved by caching the results of SQL queries in the temporary storage. From that point, caches got more use cases and developed additional features such as persistence and more. Memcached primary goal is still to be used to cache your database queries, whereas Redis has developed a huge set of features. To run this test, I create all infrastructure from scratch every time using Terraform. For this test, I used a medium instance because Redis is single-threaded and can only be scaled horizontally by forming a Redis cluster. Additionally, I create EKS cluster and deploy Prometheus, Grafana, and other monitoring components along with 20 clients per cache to generate load. Then I slowly increase the number of clients until both tools I'm testing fail, and I usually run a test for 1.5 to 2 hours. I use the latest available versions at this moment, 7.4.1 for Redis and 1.6.32 for Memcached. I'm using minimal configuration with mostly defaults on purpose, because most people would use it that way. I disable persistence for Redis and set the maximum clients to 10,000. On the other hand, for Memcached, I increased the memory from 64 megabytes to the VM limit, which is 4 gigabytes for a medium instance, and I also set the same number of clients. For the client, I use Go application, which I instrument internally with Prometheus metrics, and use the most popular and efficient clients for both projects. I don't use internal cache metrics. Instead, to make the test more accurate, I use the same histogram buckets and measure latency from the client side. Alright, let's go ahead and run the test. On this graph, you can see that we slowly increase the number of clients. And from the start, Redis set latency is a little bit slower than Memcached, but the get latency for the first few minutes is almost the same. However, this changes when we start to add more load to both caches. On the other hand, CPU usage throughout the test is almost identical, and you can see similar memory usage, but with a different pattern. For each set command, I use 20 seconds expiration. So both Redis and Memcached remove those objects every 20 seconds. There are some differences in network transmit usage as well. At around 50,000 operations per second, you can start to notice that Redis begins to fall behind Memcached and its latency reaches 10 to 15 milliseconds. On the other hand, Memcached stayed very stable throughout the test. Online, you can find that Memcached is a bit more performant than Redis, but as I say, latency is the most important metric here. The higher the latency, the slower the web page will load, which translates to a bad user experience. Yes, Redis has a lot more features, but honestly, do you really need them? Because it's very hard to scale and maintain large Redis clusters and constantly add additional shards and rebalance. Frequently, you start by managing your own Redis, but when the load increases, you switch to the clustered Redis for a while. After a few outages in production, you would probably switch to overpriced managed Redis, either in AWS or any other cloud. On the other hand, Memcached is really easy to run, and if you only need to cache SQL queries to speed up your database, Memcached is a great choice. So by the time we reached full CPU usage, Redis was able to handle around 94,000 requests per second, while Memcached reached 112,000 operations per second. Again, latency is the most important metric, and based on this test, you can choose for yourself whether you need the simplicity and lower latency of Memcached or the features that only Redis can offer. And keep in mind, it's difficult to maintain Redis clusters, and usually there are dedicated people in companies whose job is only to keep Redis alive. Now, let's open each graph for the entire test duration. First, we have operations per second. At around 50,000, you can start noticing a difference. You can see the maximum number of operations each cache can handle. Next, we have latency for the set operation. The latency difference is quite significant, and for overloaded Redis, I think it's equal to the latency of the SQL query itself. It reaches 35 milliseconds. At the very start, however, you can see that up until maybe 15% CPU usage, you have stable low latency. Next, we have get operation latency. The difference is pretty much the same, but get operation takes on average half the time, and for the Redis, it reaches around 20 milliseconds. Next, we have CPU usage, and in this case, it's very similar. You can rarely see that different tools reach full CPU usage at about the same time. Next, we have memory usage with slightly different pattern. And finally, network usage. Now, these are pretty much defaults. If you can improve your favorite cache, please send me a PR and I'll give you a credit and explain to others how to improve the performance. I have other benchmarks on my channel that you might find interesting. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.